been asked to tile this caravan. It's a static one. It's got 6mm Hardy backer board on it. I'm going to need to put a few more screws in it and finish off the boarding. You can't actually use a level on these static caravans, so everything has to be measured. I'll measure from the ceiling downwards. Everything is square in here. Everything is built to a square rather than level, so I'll have to carry on that same thing. Shouldn't take too long.
Well, I don't have to put some dot and dab. I don't know if you can see them, but a bit of silicone up there, and that will help when you put your board up there. You can walk away and just let it stay up there, fiddle about and get some loose. Good old rub in there. Now I have marked the top where the screws go. Allegedly. And I'll do the same, and I'll do the same with this side here. Well, what I've done here, right, I've put the screw in, I've taken it out. I need to countersink it. I found out the quickest way. You just take a masonry bit, that's about 10, but if you just put the drill in there, wrap it around. Don't try and drill through it because it's only a 6mm board. Trying to do it with my left hand. So I'll struggle a bit. Then the screw will just go in there nice and flush. That's it. That's nice and flush. I like it. Right, I'm going to show you a quick way to measure something. Leveled out. Got a mark on it. There's that there. Got a mark on it. So I'm just going to guess that middle now. That's how you do it. Give you a little to give you assistance. And that comes to 990. I'll transfer that mark over the other side. 90. There you go. And a level through there. I'm not looking for level, remember this caravan is not level. I'm looking for measuring off the ceiling because everything in it is built square. So I want a line through there. I'm just going to run a short line through there first, not waste my ink. I'm going to take my pencil. Now I'm going to bond out. I want to see the best cut I've got. So start from that line. I'll just bond out. Give myself 2.5mm. Somewhere near there. Can't get 2.5mm, just it doesn't. Now that gives me a cut up there of a third. Now we know the tile is 150mm, so now I'm going to measure half the tile, which is 5 in my case ish. Now I'll see. Now if I put this mark on the line, 75mm mark, and then try it again. I can see which is the best cut. I want the biggest cut I can get. Because these are the very thin tiles, I can cut 15 mil off the tile quite easily. I'm just going to double check down, go towards the end. You probably won't see this, but it's just, it should mirror the same as the top. Says a full tile, but I know that shower tray's out. So I'm going to go for the first time I did it that way up, because that shower tray is out, and I really don't want to play with a full tile down there. I'll just double check, so that's all we'll go up. Yeah, that'll be fine. And I'll do the same with the centre. I'll do the centre, and I'll mark, and I'll bond out from the centre. On the line, or halfway. So I've got a line here, like so. I'll first do it like that, and then I do half a tile. One, two. I'll do that. I'm going to mark 600, which is now the centre of the wall, which is there. Same again. That's a 15 mil. I can do 15 mil because they're thin. If these tiles were thicker, you know, really, maybe large format, I'd go for a different one. I'd go for another cut, which is the half cut, isn't it? Which is, would be about there. That's half up. I will measure. That's just purely for that. It's just to show you. And I will do that. And this cut to that side, see, and there, actually that's a nicer cut to that line there, so that would be just over 3/4 cut. I'm happy, well happy, that would be so easy to cut, so I'm going to go for that. I'm going to have my tile. If you can see this, I've got a line now all the way around behind me and tucked into the back of the wall. I've used the levels I'm using, it's not for level but for straight edge now. Just put on a couple of trowels. Start here where you like. Much on as you can up to that point. You don't want to leave any unglued places on your tile. You're aiming for 70% coverage over that tile. That's what you're looking for. That's good. 70% is good. So two of them, plonk it on. Don't be fussy, just keep on like crossways, and then you want to go all the same way. Keep it the same way. That means that your tile will push in evenly along rather than have it going crossways and down. It's just a little
So there's my line now. So I'm going to go just slightly to the follow this line. I'm not too worried at the moment. Now I know that's a cut tile there. That's just slightly two things right. And then I'll cut the other side. And I'll just follow that line. No matter what the tiles look like at this moment, don't worry about that too much. Because we're going to put a straight edge on that bottom. Keep them fairly close. I'm going to go, well, that's 2.5 mil. Right, keep the level clean. And that's your first lot. Put a bit more adhesive on this one. You just run them through. 2 mil, 2 mil, two and a half mil. You are going to differ. No tiles are the same size because they're made so quickly now. Look at your sizes. You can get in there. What you can do is a trick. Is to, because you put a straight edge or a level on the top line there, then you know they're butted up to the top line. If you just look down like that, you can see which of these tiles are out by looking. And so you always level the top ones. They look alright to me. And then just stand back, just stand away from your job. See? That one can come over a bit. That's just right, arm's length is about right. Now we just carry on like that. So I'll carry on and do that part, and then we'll do some cutting. I'll let it run for a few minutes. Because I don't want that, adhesive to dry. Some cuts. You can always feel if there's a lump in there somewhere. You hear your trowel scrape. You just put your finger out and you'll feel it. See that? What? Go back to there again. You don't need spacers half the time, or any time. Just get your eye in. You should be able to see a wonky tile. The thing with spacers is they don't take into consideration shape of the tile, you see. That's the only problem with them. But they've got their job to do.
keep them close. Okay, now I need to cut some tiles. Poor old bones don't want to do this. Okay, £1 for 100 of these. What you do is you want to cut this corner here, right? So you turn that way, mark the tile, that corner, do the same up against the wall. So I've got two marks on there. Now you want to take 5mm off. Because you're coming at the end of it, it doesn't matter. It makes no difference. You cut the end of this wall here. There's no other tile to butt up to, so you can guess it. Marks it. I put some ink down there so you can see. So really what you've got to do is to just somewhere there, put it. Rub the ink off. There you go. So that's what I'm going to do all the way down here. I'm going to measure them though, all individually. To cut them into the wall. Right, if it comes to this, I've made, scratched it on the cutter, I put a pen line in it and rubbed it in. So this is another little cutter that comes in handy, a snapper. There you go. Here's a little tip for you, it's a quick measuring process. If I measure to, you may not be able to see the end of this board to the wall there. I'll measure this, and this comes to 785, right? Which is near enough 800, so I'll go put a mark at 400, which I've done already. 400. Then I'll measure 400 back that way. That gives me that mark there, and so I take in the middle of that mark, put a circle in it, and now that's the centre of the wall. That's just a quick tip for when you're measuring. It just does it that much quicker and less error this way. Thank you.
compass away. Right. And down to the centre of that mark there. It was a bit tricky running into that corner, but it's doable. I'm going to have to lean over past the camera, but it's to that line, same attitude, yeah. Too shabby. Right, I want all the cuts all the way down, nice and even. Right, as this is a caravan and we mentioned before, this line is running to the measurement. Now I've marked this, a little bit of mark on the tape there, that's like 90, so I need 990 this end. That's right there. That side is a little bit higher than that, so I'll get the level in there. Need a straight edge. That'll do. So what you don't want is that wall to lean back or that way, which it will do if you use a level. If you go by the level, the bubble, if you go by that bubble, you're going to be wrong. You've got to measure down, because these caravans are made in a factory and assembled in a factory. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come down there now. I'm going to come down here, around here, form a line across there and then do those cuts around the pipes. Right, now how I'm going to cut this tar here is I'm going to go, this is just roughly slightly proud of that hole. plateau somewhere there, the same thing, which gives me a square. More or less. So I'm just gonna, I should put a hole in there somewhere, like so. But because this has a backing plates on it, this shower, I'm actually just gonna cut through there, round there and through there. And because it fits, I don't need to cut the other side. Right, now how I'm going to cut this tile here is I'm going to go, this is just roughly, slightly proud of that hole. Put the tile somewhere there, do the same thing, which gives me a square. More or less. So I'm just gonna, I should put a hole in there somewhere, like so. But because this has a backing plates on it, this shower, I'm actually just gonna cut through there, round there and through there. And because it fits, I don't need to cut the other side. I can't see this at the moment, but I'm going to go three tiles up. It's slightly flexy. Not over flexy where it slumps. If you normally go, what I normally do is go three tiles out, this I'm going to do two, I think that's all the camera can reach at this minute. Tile clips on. Find my pen again. You could start from the top and go down, doesn't make any difference. Now I'm ready to go up again. I'm filling the blanks. Careful, the caravan shakes when I bang it. I'm going to put another one on top of that, you can't see it. But just do three in a line so you get a basic
level.
I'll put it back on. Can't probably see now, you can't see this last cut, but I'm just going to copy this cut on this corner from that last one, and they should just go straight up. Right, the cutter is set up, so I'm going to use that one I just measured there, it should fit. And it does. You can turn the cuts, you can turn the edges in if you need to, but because we're having a shower door going down here, and we've got the board sticking out anyway, so there's not a lot we can do. There's board sticking out the wall, so we can either hide that with a piece of trim, possibilities are endless. Right, don't forget to have a wipe up, grout lines. We don't want any of this glue grinning through the nice white grout. Going to use an anti-mould grout, an anti-mould silicone. If you can see this, I've put the shower on, because sometimes it's a bit of a tight fit, and this was, so you leave plenty of room around your holes. You don't really want that touching the copper, and you don't want a grout in there because it reacts with the copper. This will be siliconed in around there, and that will be siliconed in there, otherwise the pipes will go green and eventually rot. See, that's where the tile clip comes in on its own. Can't really see because it's, I can't get far enough away. Not bad job at all. See, those cuts are quite precise and they do look good from here. And those corner cuts here, they really do look nice. They're really spot on. But that's all going to be siliconed. And these bottom cuts here, really is. Good old tile clip probe.